This podcast is brought to you by Moneycontrol.
As the appraisal season is around the corner and the employees are rushing to fill in their performance records. As we know, depending on the past year's performance, the quantum of hike and variable payouts are decided. But any error can damage the chances of a promotion. I'm Shraddha Sharma and welcome to today's episode of FutureWise. What we will discuss with M. Saraswathy today is on this, as to how you can ensure a good appraisal. Hi Saraswathy, welcome to the show.
Hi Shraddha.
So before we begin, could you please help us understand what are the factors that impact a good hike?
So as far as a yearly hike or a yearly appraisal is concerned, first of all, the economic conditions affect that. As we know that in India, of course, there has been a slowdown-like situation for the past 16 to 18 months. So anything which is related to your future or which is related to any hike or salary compensation will be related to the economic slowdown. Because if the economy is not doing well, a company may not have a future projection of good sales or good revenue. So they may not be able to give you a good hike. Specifically, because of an economic slowdown, say sales are hit, for instance, the auto sector has seen a big impact as far as sales is concerned. And various studies have shown that the auto sector may obviously offer one of the lowest hikes, which could be as low as 7 to 8%, whereas other sectors like IT and e-commerce may offer 10% and above. So your economic slowdown affecting your expansion plan is another reason why your salary hike is impacted by it. Now, salary hike is also used as a retention tool. However, when companies' future projections as well as future strategies are not clear because of how the economy will move or whether or not the project that they have set up will take over or take up in a big way, your salaries may get impacted. So this time around, economic slowdown seems to be the biggest factor that will impact your salary hike this year.
All right. And one important point you note that it has been used as a retention tool, because whenever there is high attrition rate in any of the sectors, the hike is used as a retention tool for the employees. Also, if I talk about the hike component, is it good to have a higher variable component?
So typically, your salaries have a fixed component as well as a variable component. Now, the variable component obviously depends from one company to the other. The higher you grow up in the hierarchy in an organization, the higher is the variable pay. So for instance, the CEO may have as much as 55 to 60% of their annual compensation as variable pay, whereas someone who's, say, at a mid or a junior level may have, say, 10 to 20%. Now, what a lot of people think is that variable pay, since it is something that is linked to your performance, this is something that you will easily get. For instance, if, say, 50 or 60,000 is my annual variable pay, it is incorrect to presume that you will end up getting all the entire 60,000 as your variable if your performance is good. Because it is not just depending on your performance, your KRAs and your sales targets, everything may be met, but you still end up only getting 80 to 90% of the variable pay. Because if a company is not doing well, or say some of your team members are not performing well, that also reflects on the overall company's performance and your variable pay gets hit by it. So typically when every year when the salary hike negotiations are on, one important thing is to note that too much emphasis on variable pay should not be put in. So 10 to 20 or maximum 30% of variable pay is okay. But say if someone who's in a mid-management level, if 50% of his or her pay is variable, then there is a lot of uncertainty as to whether you will end up getting that money or not.
All right. So not only your performance, but the company's performance, but how the economic environment is around the company as well. That plays a major role, you said. Mm. Also, you spoke about the levels, the seniority of an employee. Is it the only factor that affects promotions?
So as far as promotions are concerned, say 10 to 15 years ago, it was purely based on seniority. So someone who's, say, at a mid-manager level, next year would be promoted to senior manager and things like that. But now with a lot more millennials entering the workforce, that seems to have changed. So someone who's, say, 10 years younger to you could be your manager, or someone who's just joined the workforce in next 4 to 5 years may come up to head the company. So these days, it is your individual performance as well as what are the specific niche skill sets that you bring to the company. That is what matters. Also, a lot of companies have policies related to promotion. So some companies have a fixed rule as to an individual who is promoted this year may only get a promotion the next 2 to 3 years. So they have these gaps that they have so that it doesn't happen that only one individual gets promoted year after year while the others miss out. So it is not just seniority, but the company policies as well. And also how you're qualified in some of these new skills in, say, technology, AI, data, and among others.
All right. Saraswathy, I'm also ready to fill my appraisal form. What are the pointers you have to give me and the listeners today to keep in mind?
So actually, a lot of us tend to ignore these appraisal forms and tend to fill it up just for the sake of it, thinking that, say, I may have a good rapport with my reporting manager or the HR head, and thinking that, you know, my performance is what they will be looking at and not just the forms. However, if it's a small setup, obviously, you know, this team is small and a lot of us know each other. So it becomes easier for the HR manager to also find out what your performance has been in the past year. However, when it comes to a large setup, it is increasingly difficult for the HR head to figure out how your performance has been vis-a-vis your other team members. So it is very important to fill out every major as well as minor achievements that you may have done. It's not just achieving, say, the 50 crore or the 1 lakh sales target that you may have achieved, but also, say, helping a company in time of a crisis or during a brand crisis, for instance. Say, for instance, we've heard of the Maggie incident wherein there were some doubts raised on the quality of the product and whether it is safe for consumption. A lot of employees who had helped, you know, the brand kind come through the crisis and get back into the market were rewarded very well by the company, because, you know, that was a period of crisis where there was a fear of a lot of employees quitting because of the uncertainty. So how you've performed in, say, times of crisis, as well as over and above the sales target, when you've gone over and above your mandate and done something to help the company as a whole, that is what these companies look at. So also there have been situations wherein your reporting manager may be in a different city or in a different country if it's a large global organization. So it is also crucial that you help them understand the regional context as far as your role is concerned and how important your role may be as far as the country is concerned. So, for instance, a company which is based in the US may or may not understand how critical your role is in India. So they may or may not be able to assess you properly. Hence, it is also crucial that you mention how you have contributed to that company's particular performance in the regional context. Also fill out all those minute details with respect to that. One also important thing is to not exaggerate any of our achievements. I know it is very tempting to kind of mention that how you've helped the team scale up or how you've helped the team set up a new operation somewhere. But most of it is usually team effort, and hence if you end up taking all the credit to yourself, that also may seem as a negative.
All right. So some important points to keep in mind also to not exaggerate your performance. But also, is there any activity that might be considered inappropriate if you had to talk about it?
So, you know, closer to appraisals, poaching, of course, by rival companies is one of the most common things that happen in India as well as globally. Now, what we've seen a lot of employees do is that they end up taking offers from rival companies and, you know, presenting it to the HR to get it matched or, you know, get your salary hiked over and above of what you were intended to get. I know in the short run, of course, probably if you are someone with niche skills, you may end up getting a much better salary hike than the others. But in the longer run, HR managers see it as a complete negative and it's considered inappropriate at the workplace. As part of your salary negotiations in the workplace, of course, you can have a discussion with your HR manager as to why your salary should be X and not Y. But getting an offer from a rival company and trying to present it or trying to use it as a threat to increase your salary is something which I see a lot of employees are doing these days, but that is something that is a big no-no.
All right, Saraswathy, some important points for me and the listeners to keep in mind. Yes, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
With that, it's a wrap on this episode of FutureWise. If you have any queries, do write to us on mcpodcast@nw18.com. For more news, views and other updates, stay logged on to Money Control.